What's up, everybody? I am so sorry. I had to run and do something real quick before we started, but welcome in. Are you ready, Blood Trip?
I am ready.
This has been a long time coming. I can't believe we started to set this up in September, and then just we were busy all of October. Half of November,
yeah.
And then so far every Saturday in December I've been busy as well, so haven't been able to do it then. And then last Sunday when we were supposed to do it, we lost internet here, so
yeah.
Wasn't able to fucking do it then either, but we are ready to finish Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. What were we, 88%? Yeah, we were 88%. We're going to have this game done today. We're going to be starting up Ratchet & Clank afterwards. Welcome in, Black Belt. Welcome in, Blood Trip.
You mean Jack Daxter?
What did I say?
You said Ratchet & Clank
again? No, we're actually just going to re-fucking start this now that I said that. So, fuck it. No. Everyone, we're just doing this again after. Ignore the title now. Okay. So what had happened at the end of last stream? Do you remember? We were back on that big planet with Ratchet, with where we were using the rocket boots a lot. The dimensions are getting like twisted together, right?
Yes, and I believe we also went back to the bar with the tournament.
Yes, we did do that, and we did the next cup.
This universe's Emperor Nefarious showed up.
You're totally right. Yep. And then he took the old one somewhere.
Yeah.
Because we went through that big door with Ratchet and something happened. And I can't remember now.
Getting close to the prison.
All right. Welcome in, everybody. Lurking an hour before. I appreciate the dedication. Unfortunately. You know what I would appreciate more? If I could actually do things on time. That's what I would appreciate. That's what I would appreciate more in myself. And I'm sure Crazy Dragoon and everyone else is probably right there with me. So I'm trying. Didn't get a hello, Ambi. I'm sorry, I didn't say hello to everyone either. I just kind of stopped after and lost my train of thought. But hello, Ambi. Welcome in, Crazy Dragoon, who's been here for over an hour lurking. I appreciate the dedication. And hello, Pluto. How are you doing? Pluto, I very much appreciate the wake-up message, because let me tell you, that could work some days. I was, in fact, awake. I wasn't feeling great, so I was getting a couple things done. We have, like, my grandmother's in the hospital kind of thing, so we're kind of, like, watching. Okay. I see what I was supposed to do, but I just want it on the record that she could have pulled herself up on that. So we've just been, like, watching that situation. So it's been a lot recently, plus with the holidays and everything.
Yeah.
So I'm glad I'm still streaming and getting everything done, so I do apologize for being a little bit late. But welcome in, everyone. Ambi, do you have work today, or are you off? It's a Sunday, and you're not... Well, to be fair, it's 2 o'clock. I'm not used to doing this early. And what I mean by early is just not before nighttime.
I wonder if we're having a holiday party at work.
Haven't heard anything about it?
No.
That's so funny, because we were supposed to be finishing up the GTA 5 heist tonight with Dante.
Yeah.
But as per Dante, he messaged Nick today and said... I have a holiday party tonight to go to. So, we'll see what's happening. Well, I was like, wait, isn't Spirit supposed to be streaming? And it was the time. I was like, what the fuck is he doing? But thank you, Pluto. I appreciate it. It's one of those situations where she's been on the cusp for a while. She's very old, and
yeah.
She's very weak, so it's kind of just like, we hope she gets better, and we hope she gets out of there. I just want her to be comfortable, you know?
Yeah.
She hates the hospital.
I don't think anybody enjoys it.
And I just want to set this scene really quick, because she is the sweetest old lady. Like, she is the definition of old and frail. Like, very, like, oh, you're very nice. Nice to meet you kind of thing. And we heard from the nurses at the hospital that she was slapping the nurses and spitting at them.
What the fuck?
And this is how crazy she got. It, like, 3 nights in the hospital. This is where she got
to.
She called my aunt. And said, you need to get me out of here. They are torturing me in a room behind the bathroom. And honestly, with my experience in the medical field, I am more inclined to believe my grandma that there is a torture chamber in the bathroom in the hospital than I am inclined to believe the nurses are just doing what they need to. But Either way, she's fine during the days.
Yeah.
It's the nights that make her go crazy, so we're just hoping that everything kind of gets a little bit better.
That's
nuts. I appreciate it. Yeah, you're not kidding. Just got your degree certificate today. Dude, nice. With my grandmother, they took her off her usual meds, and she basically had the same reaction. It's crazy what can just set you off like that. Should we get the warmonger? This sounds cool.
Yes.
Should we just go for it and get the other, get this one, that being that we have the bolts for it, or should we save up for the cold snap?
Save for the cold snap.
Got it. Alright. I just want to, remember the controls and everything. R2 shoot. I was like, what button is it to change the weapon then? Oh, right, because these were almost all done. We have the drill hound and the ricochet. And then, yeah, all of these ones we haven't really touched.
Yeah.
That, you know what? That might be the last weapon. Wait, no, that doesn't make any sense. Because there's two weapons left.
Yeah.
So is there going to be a third wheel? There's a lot of fucking weapons, bro. Holy shit.
Jeez.
I was like, oh, if there's only one, that would make sense. Especially because we're at the end of the game, but... Oh, well. Are you still streaming later? Yes. I will either be we're kind of waiting on Dante to know if we're going to be finishing up the heists. But whether we do that or not, we'll definitely be doing some GTA stuff. So. I can't tell if that was just dialogue or if I should be doing something.
Well, that's the way we came.
Right.
Oh, phase through it. I think it's circle.
Circle.
Yes.
Processing center.
Thank you.
It has to be where Ratchet and Clank are being held. And Kit.
Intruder! I will destroy you in 5 minutes.
It's funny because I'm using the ricochet, but everything dies in one hit, so I can't even ricochet it. There it is. Alright, that's probably where we're supposed to be going. So... Or maybe this is where we're supposed to be going. I love that.
That looked like a lot more money than normal.
Yeah, right? Yeah, really quick, I just want to run back and make sure that I couldn't go that way. Oh, and I missed a lot of boxes. Whoa! I honestly figured once I stood on this, it would start moving. Will it?
Ah.
I see. But, oh, and welcome in, Axta. How are you doing? Hey, autocorrect. Welcome in, Axta. It is not on Xbox. I am playing on my PS5 currently. I have both. Oh, I was, waiting for the button prompt. So is this where we're supposed to be going? It is. So I was... Oh, come on. Alright, cool. No!
Ah, so all right, close.
I might have to... Alright, let's see what I should be doing. I'm playing on my PS5 currently. Yes, I have most consoles, luckily. I do have an Xbox Series X, and usually... Wait. Okay. I'll take the XP. Oh. No! Oh, thank God.
They should come back. Yeah.
Alright, yes. So that's where we're supposed to be going. So, let's not go that way.
Just yet.
Yeah. Once I started going this way for a while, I was like, wait, is this where I'm supposed to be going? Oh, okay. Oh, the big guys aren't respawning. Okay. Don't have a Wii U, though. Who cares? True, I do not have a Wii U. I don't plan on getting one. I remember when COVID was still a thing, just Ratchet & Clank was free to keep. Yes, they put out one of the Ratchet & Clank games that you got to keep, and I thought that was so cool. We should probably play that at some point. That was the PS4 one. Was that the one based on the movie that was based on the game?
It was another one of those...
Fucking A.
It was another one of those... interactive displays back there.
Okay, so let's see where that one's going to take me. I'm only missing two. I guess at the end of the game, we'll kind of see what we're missing and see if we want to do anything, but... I wouldn't mind moving on. So, can I stand on that? That was a bold way to find out if I could stand on that. What is this? Oh. I missed Raritanium back here. I kind of just want to go back really quick. But yeah, where would that bring me? Let's go sit. But I don't need one, Ambi, because whenever we do our Wii U stream, it'll be on your Wii U. What did it do?
It brought a platform over to the left.
Is that the platform?
Yes.
Okay, so I wouldn't have been able to... That was odd. So I wouldn't have been able to do what I was doing without it. Okay, so yeah, let me go back and get the Raritanium first. How did I miss that? There they are. Oh, it was kind of hidden.
Probably shoot it. No, wait.
Oh. I was like, actually, that might be a good idea. I don't think I should stay on this track. Plus, have you ever played Team Fortress 2 on PC? I have not. I do know it. And it's not my kind of game, typically.
Now, did you get it all?
You mean the... I really assumed so, so I'm glad you said something. So where's the other one? I'm gonna put a... I'm just bad at what I do. This one was further back there. You know, if I took 2 seconds and looked to my right... Alright, we're clear now. We're clear. Nah, man, I think it's important for all Earth citizens to own a Wii U. This is my stance for president, by the way.
See if we can upgrade anything.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Now that we have the rare opinion. I'll put my own everything. So, we were working on the ricochet. You know what? I feel like I want to hold off because the ricochet is almost done. Because we can upgrade the buzz blades. We can upgrade. We just got that actually. Should I start with that? Come
on back. Do the ricochet when it levels up.
Okay. So we'll wait till that.
But that is a lot of options for the warmonger straight off the bat.
I wonder if there's levels for the warmonger. Level 2. What?
You already leveled it up.
I just got it. I haven't used it. That's weird. No. Interesting.
Oh, didn't we do one of the tournaments?
We did a yes with the weapon, and that's why. That makes sense. Every time you play a game that's free, or if I own it, I'm like, I think I'm going to download it.
That is cool.
There you go. Yeah, that's cool that like we were able to use it, and it still counts the levels and shit. That obviously makes sense as to why there were so many things to upgrade.
There's a thing over there.
What thing?
The portal.
Right there?
Yeah.
Yes. This is where I was going before. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, so I'll pull myself here, and that makes sense because now I can make that jump. Oh.
Oh, you can even break the fence.
Good to know. Because that would have been bad had I not known that and then broken the fence without knowing. Whoa. The ricochet. Oh, that is so cool. Okay. But now we're gonna do the drill hound. I'm glad that the camera put me there because I don't know if I would have looked. Alright, was there anything else I missed over here? Just because the gameplay looks sick? Oh, hell yeah, dude. I haven't played the one for PS4. This is the PS5 exclusive one. This is a Rift Apart. So I've never played any of the other Ratchet & Clank games aside from Deadlock, but that's one of the PS2 titles. So I don't know what that the PS4 one looks like, but I've heard it's very good. Oh god. Take that. That fan doesn't look all that sturdy. This might be the first time we've ever been told to do that.
Yeah.
That's a weird mechanic.
I've just been using that.
Yeah, just for the game. So funny. Alright. And yeah, nothing else. Alright, cool. I saw another retaining there. There's Clank, but I don't see Ratchet. Okay. You've played this one before, Axta, or you just like how you've seen gameplay? Might have been all of them now. Were we only missing the one, or do we have... Oh, we're missing one more. All right. This bounty ain't worth it. We got him to break out of here. Dude, your biceps will never fit through that. What? First time seeing Rift Apart gameplay? Gotcha. I really do like this one. Have you played any of the other Ratchet & Clanks aside from the PS4 one? I'm just curious, because I would love to play more of this series, and I know that you have a couple. Which one did you have? Up Your Arsenal?
I have Up Your Arsenal. Okay. I used to have Going Commando.
Okay. Where are you guys? Something tells me I shouldn't open this. But something tells me I'm going definitely to. Here. It makes sense that I wouldn't just be able to open it. I feel like I should be able to go through the bars, but yeah. She's thinking about it. I love that. Have you seen someone who looks like me?
No. You can talk to the pirates.
You know what? They're always funny, so I may as well. Snuck me after me, booty. Okay, that was painfully not funny. And now I'm upset.
It was funny that it wasn't.
Yeah, you know what? That's true. Another day, another chance to please the Emperor with my unconditional loyalty. Take it for a second. Okay, well, Nick just texted me and said, it looks like Dante is going to stay home, so we will be doing the GTA heists. But then he said, it looks like we have to use Discord for a call instead of Xbox. So he was like, how do you make that go? And I'm like, I haven't used Discord calls to do streaming at all. So I'm like, I prefer not to. And I'm like, I don't really know how that's going to work. And I was like, oh, I bet he doesn't have an Xbox mic because Dante's ridiculous like that. Nothing like a piece of chocolate after dinner? It's different. There you go, Pluto. Hell yeah. You haven't played any others. Okay, Axta. But I should try the PS4 one. If you say it's good, I'll do it. Ooh, and here's the hydrate for you. I've decided I'm finishing the Kitakami decks before the next DLC release on Thursday, so I'm currently looking at the 50 or so you have left.
Nice.
Hell yeah. Fucking hate Conkeldurr, by the way. He's so ugly. So apparently Conkeldurr is in it. But welcome in, Black Belt. How are you? Bunch of other things right after I send my prayers to Sean. There's Discord integration on Xbox. Oh yeah, I forgot they did that. Okay, that should be pretty easy then. That should be pretty easy. I do have it, Axta, so maybe that we'll put that on the list. I have the PS4 Ratchet and Clank we can give a shot to.
Drillhound leveled up.
Fuck yeah. Alright, plus I should be able to test it real easy. But welcome in, Black Belt. I can't believe I finally did that Guitar Hero stream. That hurt my hands. I didn't like it.
I was saying, am I locked in?
I did. And you know what? I did the math, too. I FC'd a quarter of the game. Because if there are 73 songs, a quarter of it is 18.25. And I FC'd 19 songs right off the bat. So I'm pretty happy with that. And about 10 or 12 more of them right in the beginning of the game. I only missed one note because of a simple choke. But I was pretty happy with that. You know what? There's a good reason I'm sure that it's giving us so many bolts, and it's probably to pay for the last two weapons. Because we are... After this box set, I'm pretty sure we can pay for... Yeah. Yeah, we have enough for the 20,000 one. And the other one was only like 4,000, so... Thank you, Black Belt. It was fun to do it. And I did have a couple people that, I mean, Black Belt, or, you know, Blood Trip was sticking around for the whole time. Pluto was there for a lot of it.
Jimmy was there for a good bit of it, but he was taking a nap.
I wish I was taking that nap. So, I'm probably going to do some more Clone Hero streams, so we can totally do some Clone Online? I forget what you call it. Clone Line? Clone Line. That's hilarious. But, we could totally do some of that together on stream. I think that'd be a lot of fun. And people want to do requests, so... I might, like, start downloading some other songs for it. Now that I know it does work on stream, I don't know why I was having the issues I was having, but as long as I got it to work, I'm pretty happy with that. Yes, Ambi did congratulate me on my excellent fingering skills. I think I'm not going to download Ratchet and
Clank. Phrasing!
Right now. Axta, it's so... Archer is perfect.
I've never seen it. I really should watch.
Really?
It.
You would love it. How have you not watched it?
I have no.
Oh my god, Bloodshot, you're going home tonight. And you're watching Archer. I don't care what you. I don't care.
Because like I love Bob's Burgers.
Oh, you would just love it so much. I'm out here being Axta's number one influencer for all the games they're playing right now. The last three games, because I know they downloaded Fall Guys the other day when I was doing Fall Guys, which, Axta, I will be doing again this week, so me, you, and Camouflag, and anyone else who wants to join, come and join. We're gonna win. I'm sorry I had to work. Yeah, I can't believe you, Ambi.
Yeah, I know.
Try the Warmonger.
Let's see.
That's on the second page. We could probably move some around, that way we don't have to go to the second page anymore.
I think we could use this one. I think this will work.
Oh, yeah, that should.
Yes.
One thing told me to go fuck myself and I work 9 to 3. Oh my god. I'm sorry, Ambi, that sucks.
Nope, didn't work.
I
to Ratchet and Kit cells, who's there?
Avoid the ricochet.
This is even more chaotic than Savali.
Sorry I left you behind back there, Bolts. Things got complicated.
I understand. There was a lot of chaos.
No, yeah, that.
Okay, wait, speaking of chaos, that just reminded me. Sepultura, man, what the fuck?
I know!
Like I said in chat, I just read that
yeah.
It's funny because that may have been a couple ideas that came to my mind at that. I was like, is that Andreas Kisser maybe saying they're not going to do another album because they were breaking it off? Or was that Andreas Kisser saying those were his plans and no one else in Sepultura wants to continue, so they're it could be Derek Green saying he doesn't want to do it anymore and then just not wanting to find another vocalist.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's like the statement said, this has been like a plan in the making for 2 years?
So that's why it's like, where did that come from?
Somewhere over here.
But who knows? Imagine that PS4 version start was the best.
Shit.
Ooh, I gotta see it. What, did you die?
Yeah.
Damn. I mean, there's a lot of enemies here. There's a lot of fucking enemies here. Oh, good. You just got the checkpoint, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
Somebody.
Yo, Klingending. No, that was the sub. This was the person I was just telling you about. So, okay. I'm Spirit of Black.
Welcome in, Klingon.
This is my friend. And we're streaming Ratchet and Clank. For those of you, I just... Ooh, hold on, wait. Ah. I just had to read that text. I was actually watching his stream last night of Final Fantasy VII Remake, and I was literally telling Blood Trip right before we started, I've always wanted to see people do the late level grinding and shit like that, and their stream title was quite literally grinding out some later levels and stuff like that, and I was like, perfect. I'm in. Give him a quick follow as he was ending stream, so I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you made your way over here. Great to meet you. And, yeah. So, okay, obviously, you said you're a metalhead. He's a metalhead, too. Let's hear some bands. We got some we have some metalheads in chat right now, so let's do it. Let's talk about it. But welcome in, my man. I've been helping doing Quantum Mind from time to time. Hell yeah. Oh, and yes, I was going to ask you for to help set up a request system, so hell yeah. Maybe on Wednesday you can help me out with that. I said that, but I don't know how Ripped Apart started. Then you know what? We just won't include Ripped Apart. Stand by at Axta, and I'm willing to bet it's really good. I'll also be down to do co-op in person on Wednesdays, like once a month. Oh, that would be pretty cool. Hell yeah. Dude, don't worry about it. You know what? Here. Yeah. I still gotta give Pluto the mod. He keeps trying to do it. Hold on, I got it. Thank you, Black Belt. Favorite band of all time is Death for sure. Oh, man, you are going to fit in well here. You know what? So this is a good story to start off with. We played in a band together for a long time. Oh my god. So we actually played with a band called Inhuman Condition. They're newer.
I was wearing that wristband the other day when I went to Exodus.
Hell yeah. So we play with Inhuman Condition, which is friends of ours, Jeremy Kling and Taylor Nordberg. I don't know if you know those names. Taylor Nordberg is actually playing guitar for Deicide right now. And they're such nice guys and such cool guys. But their bass player for that project was actually Terry Butler, who played bass for Spiritual Healing. We got off stage and Terry saw me and he talked to me and he's like, dude, you got sick riffs. And
he's still
like,
the bassist for Obituary, right?
Yes, he's still playing with Obituary. He did 6 feet under for a little bit, then stopped doing that for obvious reasons. but yeah, man, we play with some really cool bands. Death, phenomenal. I'm curious, what's your favorite Death album then? But I thank you, Black Belt, for putting in the shout out. And Pluto, thank you for trying to put the shout out that I still have not given you mod for. So I will do that today. And Klingon, Ambi is our resident survey taker. She's our chatter. I know we're in real life. The survey
Surveyor.
Is not... she is... it's not a personal survey. It would make her very happy if you would want to take it, but don't feel obligated. Just saw him with Obituary a couple months ago. What tour did you see him with? I got you, Pluto. Don't worry. After this stream, I'm totally going to remember.
That must be Ratchet and Kit. We can't let them get any deeper into the prison.
Yes, I will only cry myself to sleep tonight. It's okay. But wait, Ambie, what time do you work today?
I think she said 5 to 10:15.
I totally missed it. 10:15? What the fuck, Ambie? Did you say that? That's weird. My father used to listen to a lot of Metallica back in the day. Oh, we love Metallica here. We're all Metallica fans here. Last year... Oh, hell yeah! We went to that show in the city. I don't know where you're from. I'm not gonna ask, but, we went to the city to see, that show.
Which one?
Amon Amarth, Carcass, Obituary, and Cattle Decapitation. Yeah. Let me tell you, Carcass, one of my top favorite bands of all fucking time. Heartwork is perfect.
That level, huh?
Perfect. And their newest album, incredible. Yeah. I don't think Carcass gets the attention they deserve. They're too melodic. They're almost too happy with some of their stuff, which makes because they don't look it, and it's just like, what's going on here? Very, very bizarre, but... okay, I didn't see it, but I see one of the few albums that I think is a perfect album. If it's if I scroll up and I see that you put Human, we are on point. Let me see. Human. You might just be me, actually. I'm not gonna lie to you. Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. He still has all the discs? Oh, that's awesome, Axta. Yeah, my dad just cleaned out... My god, there's a lot of enemies here.
Yeah.
Use whatever guns you want, even if you don't want to level them up. You can just go for it. Oh my god, it keeps sending you back here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's brutal. God damn. My dad just got rid of all the CDs he had. He got to the point where he's like, it's a cool collection, but I'd rather get a little bit of money for them. He said, I'd rather the CDs go to the local record store where people who want collections can get it, as opposed to them just sitting down here collecting dust. He's mostly digital at this point on iTunes. He still doesn't like streaming. Speaking of streaming, on a quick tangent, do you hear what Sony's doing? Do you hear what happened with Sony?
No.
So, obviously, people don't like streaming. Like, the people who don't like streaming, a lot of their reasons could be something like, I want to own what I have.
Yeah.
I want to just...
Oh, like with. The video game?
Discovery. Sony lost their license with Discovery, with the TV provider service or whatever. So anything that people bought through Discovery on a PlayStation, they're losing access to and not getting refunded. I'm like, wow, did you know that's actually theft?
I did see that.
So, you know, that's just something to think about. But, Kark is an all-time favorite. Dude, they're one of my favorite bands. Fucking Heartwork is... I love everything from Necroticism on. I haven't really listened to their first two albums, but I'm not a big fan of Grindcore.
Spirit doesn't like Grindcore.
Not a big fan, so I haven't listened to it. But everything on, from Necroticism past, is just amazing. Including Swan Song, which people don't typically like.
I love Swan Song.
Alright? Fucking amazing. Because on Sunday, ShopRite closes at 10, we have a runner staying extra things. That makes sense.
I do remember that, yes.
Oh my god, and Klingon has a Wii U. Holy crap. DMDF exclusive Swamp Green Scream Bloody Gore vinyl when you were there in 2016. That's awesome. Combination of me and Swamp. Definitely not for everyone. Fair enough. Swan Song criminally underrated. Absolutely. You have no idea how happy you just made Ambi knowing that you have a Wii U. Tomorrow Belongs to Nobody rips. Black Star, one of my favorite fucking riffs of all time.
That one always comes on when it moves to like. Here's your generic playlist.
Oh my god. Amazing. How long have you been playing guitar then? I'm curious. You know what? I'm playing. Okay, listen. Knowing that his music tastes are this, let me tell you something. I have...
You may enjoy this.
You may enjoy that.
Selfish plug.
Selfish plug, 100%. It's my fucking stream. I can do what I want. That's the Spotify link to my band's album. We put out an album back in 2020, and we've been a little bit not existing at the moment due to the fact that our drummer just had a kid recently. I was having health problems. As you're new, I'm type 1 diabetic, so... working alongside all that stuff.
Die, motherfucker, die, motherfucker, die.
That's just the Needler. That's sick. But hell yeah, I hope you enjoy it. I think you'll find a lot. We have a lyric video for a thrashy song that we have, Downfall of Civilization. Our groovier song has like a little visualizer video line Your Coffin. It's like a very groovy kind of death metal song, and then we have a music video for a more melodic song for Get the Faceless. up on YouTube. I don't think we have the YouTube link here. I might have X-Men's on YouTube, I'm not sure. But check that stuff out. One of my favorite bands of all time, too, is Nevermore. They're not... I hope you know who they are. I'd be shocked if you didn't know who they were.
I just saw their former guitarist the other night, Christopher Broderick.
Oh, my God.
And playing with In Flames.
He's such a monster guitarist. I feel like I'm one of the few guys that's actually missing Active Defiance. I don't know, man. Chris Broderick can write incredible riffs on his own, but I'm sure what he probably did was he left Megadeth to pursue his own creative freedom, and then probably noticed that he wasn't making nearly as much money, and was like, I think I need to find a bigger band again. And then got In Flames, and now he's making the money again. But my God, he comes up with some incredible riffs.
Which I find funny, because I'm pretty sure he was in Nevermore when they did Gigantor 2.
Yes. Yep.
And In Flames was also on that tour.
Really? That was that year?
I think so. I think it was like Overkill, Opeth, In Flames, Nevermore, Lamb of God, and Megadeth.
What was the Gigantor with that they did the DVD for? That was like Megadeth and Dream Theater and Boba Flex. And
I think that was the first Gigantor.
Wow, that's a hell of a tour to get for the first time. That's sick. Yeah, MAUSB, thank you for coming in. How are you doing? How have your streams been going? I haven't been able to stop in a little while. Oh, Fear Factory? Oh my God, I love Fear Factory. I'm going to be seeing them for the first time with Machine Head. And who's the other band on the bill? Is it Orbit Culture?
I think it's Orbit Culture, yeah.
Jesus fucking Christ, that's
And
sick.
Then
oh
a
my God.
Band from Virginia, I think, is the opener.
Alright, I got to check that. I love Fear Factory. Can't wait to see them for the first time. Their new vocalist, incredible. I haven't seen him with Burton C. Bell, and I feel like at this point that's probably for the best, because I feel like if I saw him with Burton C. Bell, I'd be upset, but here we are. I'm Groovy, hope you're well. I absolutely am, Emmy. Streams are good fun? Hell yeah. What are you playing right now? What's your current game you're going through? They were on that Gigantor DVD. Gotcha, they were. Orbit Culture is insanely good. I was supposed to see him like 3 times and missed him every damn time, and it sucks, and I'm so upset about it. But you've seen them a couple times now.
I've only seen them the one time.
What was the second time I was supposed to see them that you... Was the one time...
With In Flames.
I thought that was the second time I was supposed to see them, so I wonder what the other show was.
In Flames, Ben Dead, Fit for an Autopsy, and Orbit Culture.
Right, that was that show. Goddamn. Well, anyway... Elden Ring first playthrough in Liza P no leveling challenge. Oh my God, MEUSB. So you play Souls-like games a lot. Let me tell you, I've never played a Souls-like. And when when Liza P came out, I downloaded it from Game Pass because I play on Xbox. And I was like, let's do this. And for keep in mind, this was my first Souls-like. So for a couple of hours, I was playing the game. And I got to the first boss, and I beat the boss, and I was so happy. It was like my 11th time. And I was like, I think I have to take a break, but let's get to the building. I got to the building, and it showed the Liza P thing, and I was like, I just struggled for 3 hours to get to the title sequence. Oh my God. But, I wish I was better at it, but I gotta start playing them more, because they're really fun, and I do want to try Elden Ring. Because I've heard Elden Ring is, like, a good introduction to the series. Like, it's not usually, as difficult as, like, maybe the Dark Souls games and stuff like that. I think I've heard Bloodborne is pretty difficult, so that wouldn't be the start either, but I've heard it's an incredible game.
No!
Sophia Factory with DCB on the mechanized score. Ah, and his vocals left something to be desired. Maybe that's why he wasn't doing it at the time. Maybe that's why he wanted out of Fear Factory. But okay, well, you know what? That makes me feel better. That I'm not missing a ton. I gotta check my
board. I love this gun.
That's funny, I had my Spotify up and I had Orbit Culture on. 81, we're looking fantastic. Oh my God, I'm gonna be able to eat lunch. It's gonna be insane. Holy shit.
I guess I should max out the drill hat.
Well, we just got it before, right?
Yeah.
A Wii is not the same as a Wii U, unfortunately. Yeah, the Wii's better. I would say Elden Ring is of equal difficulty, but it gives you a lot more breathing room in between the difficult parts. Gotcha. Okay. And I feel like that would help too, because I know from just what my friend was saying when he was playing through Elden Ring that you have different ways to level up as opposed to just dying a million times in Liza P. So that's a good thing to know though.
This is gonna be a trap.
Oh, absolutely.
I guarantee.
You're fine, just hang on. So, I definitely want to try Elden Ring soon. My friend has it for the PS4, but he has it digitally, so I was trying it out there, and it seemed really fun, so maybe I'll give that a shot. Right on the albums, absolutely knows it. And that's understandable, too, you know. So there's a lot of studio tricks you can do to make it sound much more alive and stuff in studio. And he just has such an interesting vocal set. Like, there is no singer like Burton C. Bell, which is why when he was leaving Fear Factory, everyone was like, you're replacing him? That's weird, but...
I think Tatiana could do it.
Oh, Tatiana totally pulled that off. Oh, that would have been sick. Although I would not want to pull her away from Ginger at the moment.
Yeah.
There's a Sylveon outbreak? Do it, Ambi. Hell yeah. Sylveon is great for sure. Absolutely. How do you feel about Ginger? But anyway, cool to hear that you're doing like Liza P and Elden Ring. Emmy, I can't wait to catch one of your streams soon. You know, I'm going to give her a quick shout out too. We've rated Emmy USB a lot of times here, but if you don't follow her, please give her the follow. She is a very fun streamer to watch. She plays everything. I've caught her playing JRPGs like Yakuza Like a Dragon, and more recently Persona 5 Royal, all the way to games like Elden Ring and Eliza T. I saw her do Catherine as well from Atlas a while ago. Did you get all the Raritanium up there outside?
Pretty sure I did.
Okay. Yeah. I saw it and was just chatting. Oh, yeah, I saw you go up, so you're fine.
Ooh. There's armor and Raritanium.
There's a lot right here, but yeah. This is definitely just before the final fight. Do you want to take the final fight?
Oh, shit. Pocket Dimension's also over there, too.
That's probably where we get the other armor piece. I honestly haven't listened to much from them other than the guest spot on Decapitated's newest record. Klingon, the fact that you mentioned Decapitated, like, I don't... It's probably like seeing me type into my own chat. Decapitated is the... On my Spotify Wrapped, my top five songs were all Decapitated songs. Like, we're going to get along, bro. We're going to get along just fine. Decapitated is one of my favorite bands of all time. Vogue. I can credit Vogue specifically for revitalizing my guitar playing this fucking year. Period. Forward. The end. Man is insane. I don't know if you're a big Machine Head guy or not, but him being in Machine Head on the most recent album... definitely breathe some new life into the band. Of Kingdom and Crown was phenomenal. I don't know if you're a Machine Head guy, but absolutely love him. Single cleanest guitarist you've ever seen live. He's seen him live. Fuck. He got me. You win. I have never seen them. I'm just curious, Klingon, and you don't have to answer this if you don't want to. Are you in the U.S.? If I bring my Wormy to Sylveon fight, do we think Wormy will win? I think Wormy would win. What type is Wormy? Is it a pure steel type? I think it could win. You are. Oh my god. When did you see Decapitated? How long ago did you see them? Okay, to be fair, I came late to the Decapitated game. I didn't start listening to them until after Anti-Cult came out. I was listening to Liquid Metal on Sirius XM a lot, and they played Kill the Cult, and I picked up the album after hearing it and got into them from there. Pittsburgh. You know what's so fucking funny? Oh my god, I guess it was right. Spotify, I feel like everyone Spotify rap that were metalheads all showed, like, what's the one location that you have a lot in common with? And everyone that I know got Pittsburgh. But you know what? It's fucking right, apparently. It's right. Oh man, yeah, when did you see them? Wormy is pure steel and also level 90? That's gonna fuck it up. You got it. Yo, Captain Wheatloaf, thank you for the follow. Welcome in, I'm Spirit in Black. I hope you're having a good time. Saw them in Cleveland in 2010. Decapitated, Decrepit Birth, Flesh God Apocalypse, and Rings of Saturn. Holy shit. How is Decrepit Birth? I'm not a big Flesh God guy myself. You like him more than I do, for sure.
Drums go burr.
Quite literally. Yours was Cambridge, USA? Interesting. But welcome in, Captain Wheatloaf. Are you a fan of Ratchet and Clank? Or are you a fan of the metal that we're talking about right now? Whichever one. But welcome in, everybody. It's good to see everyone. It's good to see everyone and have Blood Trip play a game. That's creepy. Just everyone in the wall like that. You know what? This gives me very heavy Lilo and like beginning Lilo and Stitch vibes inside the Armada. We're gonna see Jumba in a second. Top five were for either the lesbians and Taylor Swift. That makes sense. Made me cough.
Don't know if I can make that.
Yeah, wait, where are you supposed to go? Is there a screen on here, like a monitor that you can do? Because it looks like that one's blocked off right now. Where'd you come from? Now that I can pay attention for a second.
Pretty sure I'm right there. Here.
Alright.
No, that's where I need to go.
Oh, that's where you need to go. I have no idea. I just feel like the final member the fans had before needed to sub at some point. That might be Dante. Captain Wheatloaf, are you Dante? I'm gonna dox you. But only that. Let's Get Lilo and Stitch was one of the best of early Disney Channel shows. Movies and shows. That was a show. The Lilo and Stitch series.
Yeah.
That translated well. I agree.
Crazy Dragoon.
Welcome in, dude. Please don't. Okay, by doxing, I meant just that you are Dante. I wasn't going to do anything else. But welcome in, dude. Yeah, just let me and Nick know if you're down for GTA tonight. If you're not, we'll try for next Sunday. It's no big deal. I hope you're feeling all right. You see the newest Amon Mark IV announcement? Oh, hell yeah. Them, Cannibal Corpse, Obituary, and Frozen Soul? Holy shit. I can't even fucking imagine, dude. I assume if you're going, I'll be going. Period. The end. Alright, good to hear it, Dante. I'm glad you're here, man. Oh, man. Dude, I can't wait to get back to the heists and stuff. It's so funny. We have three missions left. We have two setups and then the finale. That's all we have. It's literally just that. And it's been a year since we've done it. That's so funny to me.
Didn't even have to go into the pocket dimension.
Oh, wait, no, here, wait. Go to the map. It's separate because there's another one, right? Yeah, because now there's another piece of gear in the pocket dimension. Because there's, it looks like there's one other piece of gear and then one other golden bolt. So. Creep aside, thanks to Beeps who tossed the file my way. I really do appreciate it. Oh, dude, I'll shout out anyone here. I'm going to shout out Dante. You know what? Can everyone just... You know what? He doesn't stream, but can everyone just follow Wheatloaf? I think it'd be really funny. When you give up before you reach the goal. True, Pluto. You're not wrong. And then online is going to change forever when animals finally make the cut. True. You're not wrong. You're not wrong at all. That's happening, right? I heard that, right? That's not just you pulling that out of your ass. They're actually adding animals into online now, right? And Dante, you know what's even funnier? I really thought about this too, and I was like, we waited a whole year to get back to the heists. And now there's going to be snow on the ground again. Every time the snow is out in GTA, that's when we go back to it. But yeah, of course, Klingon. I give shoutouts to everyone, man. Anyone who pops in here who's a part of this community, always love seeing everybody. And the coolest thing about this is that everyone's here for each other. Crazy Dragoon is always here. Pluto's always here. Ambi, Blood Trip, Blackbell. We get so many people here, and it's awesome. Due to Twitch, getting a random chance and finding awesome people to talk games and music. That's exactly it. That's exactly it. You never know. The Final Fantasy VII Remake, my all-time favorite game. Why do we keep doing this to ourselves? We're going to be in full convoy cowboy outfits. It's all by accident, too. Because it really is so funny that what probably happened was we did it, and I looked at the dates. We did it December, I think it was December 18th we did the first time. Then it was December 23rd, and then January 8th. And then after that will be tonight. It's almost an entire year since we started. And what probably happened was a couple weeks early on in the new year, early this year, we probably tried, and then whether it was me or you couldn't do it like three or four times in a row, we probably just stopped and never got back to it. Yeah. January. It was December 18th, December 23rd, and January 8th. This year went by way too quick, but we're doing it. We're doing it. It's incredible. You never know who you're going to meet, Klingon. That's exactly it. There's got to be a way to open these bars, right?
Yeah.
Is this where, like, the pocket dimension is and everything? Is that this room? This establishment does not live up. Okay, not quite. It's down there. I was wondering if the pocket dimension was going to be in one of those bars as well.
Yeah.
Can you shoot into it to get the raritanium? I wonder. You know what? Modern Minecraft probably stole my heart around the same time. Whoops. That's also true. I do remember you were playing that a lot. But I don't think you ever... That was the reason. I don't think that was the... Because I think if you were just wanting to play different games, I feel like that would have... Okay, probably not. Can you try throwing your wrench in there? So you're like, all right, if that didn't work, here's a fucking rocket launcher. But I don't think that was the reason that we weren't doing it. But who knows at that point. But yeah, we got some cool streams for the end of the year. We're going to be doing Parasite Eve with Al Nora and Nick Raymond 11 on December 18th. So stick around for that in 8 days. I don't know why I said stick around. Hopefully we're going to be doing some more Jackbox games as well for the end of the year. Whether it's in the Discord server. Oh, Klingon, I do have to join your Discord server. I saw the whisper. I saw the message that you sent me with the link, but I woke up to it and then I had to get ready for the stream and everything. So I didn't have time to, but I absolutely will. To be fair, D&D became really consistent around the same time too every Saturday. That's understandable too. So it all makes sense. So we can try and finish it up now.
Where'd she go?
Yo, Captain Wheatloaf, you got the sub. Thank you, Klingon. I appreciate it, my man. Thanks for coming here and subbing and just spreading love. And absolutely, here. And here's my Discord server. We got a lot of stuff going on in it. Feel free to join if you'd like. We have, like, my schedule every week. We have, the actual going live messages, because everyone here knows that my schedule is not very accurate because I tend to sleep in. So, I do my best. But, nice to have you here, man. Nice to talk music and stuff like that. I cannot wait for you to listen to the album. I really think that you'll enjoy it. I'm usually very realistic with it, and I tell people, I'm like, hey, this might not be your thing. I really think it's going to be up your alley, so. I can't wait to hear it. And I want full criticism. If you're not a fan of it, I want to know it. So, don't pull any punches when you tell me about it after you listen to it, whenever you get a chance to. And yes, Pluto is now my personal alarm clock, basically, and it's incredible. We got a lot of raritanium. Holy shit. Crazy Dragoon, should I have a pizza? Where's my blood at? We're at 80. I think I can risk it today. What time is it right now? It's 3, actually. No, I'm going to stick with a peanut butter sandwich. Because I know I'm going to have some garlic bread with dinner tonight, so. But I appreciate the share. I love pizza. Oh, yeah. But yeah. Dante, so just let us know what you're doing tonight. If you're feeling good, if you're gonna go to the holiday party, no big deal. If you're not feeling good enough to go to the party, but good enough to stream and do some GTA, let me know. And Nick did text me about that we'd have to do it on Discord. I assume you don't have a mic, and we can do that easy because I do believe Xbox from Black Belt told me they have Discord integration, so it should be no problem. I'll have to figure out audio, but it shouldn't be an issue. Ambi, you actually heard them before. On stream. Full transparency. Hell yeah. Actually feeling kind of sick. I'm going to be on tonight. Oh, you mean... Oh, you're sure you're going to be. Okay. Gotcha. Fucking hell. That works with me. Well, I hope you feel... I hope you start feeling a little bit better at least. You already made that upgrade. Silly. Love that. Oh, you know. Okay. As long as you know. All right. I'm trying to make conversation. Alright, I'm sorry, Ambi. I'll let you have it. So what else is on the map here?
Pocket There's dimension. Another Raritanium. Pocket Dimension.
Was that the Raritanium that you just looked at on the right? Was that the one in the bar? In the jail cell?
Probably.
Alright. Let's see if we can find this Pocket Dimension. I guess, there's not really much to look at because you just came from here, right? What about this side? I see the pocket dimension. I have to imagine that's it. Did you freeze him? Is that the cryo thing? That's sick. That's awesome.
Be careful. That is a long way down.
Real life or something like that. What Spear means to say is if you you have to feel bad enough to not go to the party, but good enough so you can play GTA. There was no kind way to say it, so that was pretty good. Oh, is that it? What did you just do to pull that in? Is that inside? I can't tell if you're gonna hit a glass wall or not. That's a smart idea. That's glass.
Do I have to go?
It looks like it, actually. Okay. Give that a shot. Best Wii U game. Ooh, Ambi, that's your territory. Literally missed it last year to a snowstorm, so whatever's got to hold the tradition. Yeah, you're not allowed to go. You never. We were not really hardcore games. I really like Nintendo Land, especially the Mario game. We have a collection of every single Just Dance that came out for Wii U. That's so funny, Ambi, because you talk about the Wii U all the time, and then you're just like, I actually didn't play that many Wii U games. Someone called the only... Ambi's just never been caught because no one's played the Wii U enough to, like, question her on it. And I didn't have a Wii U for long, and even when I did, I didn't have any Wii U games. I got it for, like, the virtual console stuff on the gamepad, typically, so I can't even... I don't even know which ones to list off.
Suspicious.
Nothing wrong with that. It's often never fucking on. Yeah. You know what? That was so funny, Klingon, because I was gonna say if there was one game I would love to play for the Wii U, it would be the remake of Wind Waker. So you know what? I'm with you. Yeah, the Virtual Console was fantastic. I love the idea of being able to play an N64 game on a gamepad. Funny though, I didn't realize, which makes sense, that the gamepad had to be kind of close to the Wii U. So it made it to the recliner in the living room, but if I walked into the dining room to eat or something, it would shut off, and I'd be like, damn. Real big on SNES and GBA games. Ah, that makes sense as to why the Virtual Console would be one of your favorite spots for it. Yeah. Legitimately, I'm 11 out of 10. Wind Waker is so good. I love Wind Waker. Never got to play it much until later. Me and my friend went through it. I mean, granted, this was still like 5 or 6 years ago. But like when I was a kid, I didn't play too much of it because I was very bad at it. But fucking loved the game. So wait, is this where we're supposed to be?
I think so.
Interesting.
Emergency shutdown initiated. Jailbreak?
Looks like it. Sounds right. You are a fool for underestimating me. Witness. There's so many cool weapons. Like, this game has the coolest fucking weapons. The gamepad is effectively a wireless controller. Enjoy sitting 5 feet from the TV. True. At least it doesn't have the hassle of the wire. I remember up in my old room, wanting to play Sly Cooper, but, like, staying warm and stuff. So I would run the controller under, like, the bottom of my covers and then, like, sit in there and pretend like it was wireless because I could play with it under the blankets, and I was so happy. I remember I thought my friend was one of, like, the luckiest guys because he had a wireless GameCube controller. It was so cool. I was like, wait, you're out of ammo. What did you throw? The wrench.
Sorry to genocide Sylvians, by the way.
I wish you luck, Ambi. I hope you find the shiny. I gotta do more shiny racing streams on Scarlet and Violet. And I'm thinking, too, if anyone wants to join in, like, maybe just, like, we have one stream that we go for, like, 3 or 4 hours, and it's, like, me, Ambi, you, your brother, anyone that wants to do, like, some kind of shiny race on Scarlet and Violet, I think that'd be really fun to do. I really like the one I did with Black Belt, but because Black Belt hasn't wanted to go back to Scarlet and Violet, we haven't done another one, but I also don't blame him for not wanting to go back, so I wish you luck.
Yo, Ramen Powered Emo, welcome in, my man, how are you?
Also ask Landy. Oh, yeah, there we go, get Landy on stream. Oh, my God, does Kylie want to be on stream? Kylie's my favorite of the sisters. They really just threw a lot of enemies at you in this place, huh?
Yep.
The sniper's so cool, dude.
Yeah.
But again, Klingon, thanks for the follow last night. I appreciate the subs. I appreciate you coming out and talking stuff. We're going to have a lot of fun here. We're going to have a lot of fun. Oh, and specifically for Klingon who just joined the Discord, we do have a self-promotion section. So anyone who is in my Discord and streams or has anything going on, use that self-promotion section. Let us know when you're streaming. Let us know when whatever you want to promote is coming out. Damn. Does the XP that we get on the weapons stay?
I think so.
Oh, that's crazy good then. I feel like all you lose is like a couple of bolts, but at this point, like... What just happened? Was that him?
Maybe the other guy.
That makes more sense. Because I was like, it didn't look like the attack. I appreciate it, Klingon. I could try to talk her into it. There you go. Oh, yeah, we probably have... Yeah, what are we missing? Wait, hit circle really quick. So these are just... Oh. Never mind, you're good. I was looking at the wrong thing. It is lively today. Yeah, we got like, my Twitch is telling me 12 viewers, so all good to hear it. But your phone died, Axta? I'm glad you're, all you missed is I'm causing a genocide of Sylvians. But I'm glad to see you back, man. Axta, do you typically watch on your phone? I always like to ask how people watch, whether it's on like a mobile device, laptop, a console. I'm always curious to see like where the views are coming from. But Raman, you just woke up. Let me tell you, man, if I wasn't streaming, I'd be right in the same boat. And even when I am streaming, I sometimes am. I'm not very good at waking up. I'm also not very good at going to sleep. Which...
That too.
Yeah, both of those really attribute to my really shitty sleeping schedule. Did I start a stream with me playing Ratchet & Clank? Yo, Axta, do you stream? I'm about to give you a shout-out. Have you streamed before, Axta? And you watch on phone. Gotcha. I assume you're charging it now. Yeah, Robin Powered Emo streams. Dude, we got everyone here is... Oh, I love this community. It's so cool. And this game is so good.
What are you doing in here?
That is quite literally just a rocket launcher. That is awesome.
Stop moving, bitch.
You've streamed a lot, but just started on Twitch. Where were you streaming beforehand? Everyone, give Axta a quick follow as well.
Stop fucking moving.
Yeah, Ramen does a lot of JRPGs and shit like that. Like, they were just doing the Yakuza series. I think they're doing one of the Trails games now, they were saying.
So much fun.
Also, yeah, all that's left is Ambi streaming. We're back up to... Did you buy that weapon for 20,000?
Yeah.
Holy
fuck. I bought the Colt's now.
God, we're back to 29,000 already. That's insane.
Fuck. Ah, I need help.
There are so many. You want me to give a shot?
Sure.
All right, let's see. Did it give us a save at all? No, it didn't. Okay. So, what kind of guns do we have? You know, let's use drone. Let's see what we can do with the gun. See, if you jump, they can't get you, because who's going to shoot at someone in the air? Right? That would just be stupid. Makes sense to me. I'm going to use the... you know what? No, I'm going to play it smart. I'm going to save the Warmonger, because I know that I'm going to need it when all of those dudes start chasing me.
I think when everybody starts swarming in, the lightning rod would work.
Oh, you're totally right. I'll catch up on chat when I win this. I say as I got shot. Okay. Let's go to the Warmonger. Yeah, this is exactly where you keep dying. I totally see why.
Like, the melee ones are easy to deal with.
I feel like
it's the ones that keep shooting you.
Yeah. You know what? I was gonna say, let's take them out first, because you're totally right. It's these guys that are doing the damage. And then me falling off the edge. Third shot, Pixie?
Yeah.
Alright. Alright. Wow, I used a lot of ammo. Bombardier, yeah. Oh, shit. That was tough. Ratchet and Kid before it is too late. Yeah, just have to get out of here first. The office is sealed. How do we get out? Maybe that window leads somewhere. This window?
You think?
I would assume this window. Yeah, absolutely. Sorry, stream. Hell yeah. I meant to stream, but just been busy. Want to finish that game and Amby picked for me to play. Which game did she pick? I didn't even know she picked one. That's so cool. What game? Or maybe I did know and just forgot now, but that also sounds like me. Alright. Yeah, that's nice.
That's outside.
Oh, that's a good point. I hope not. I'm gonna go with no.
Yeah.
I did look it up. At the very least, nothing is missable. So, at the very least, we won't lose everything forever.
Raritanium all the way down on the left.
Oh, this is the, this is that room with all the... Okay. Up top here, right?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I went way further than I thought I was going to. There it is. Awesome. Because that was that. Where is the gold bolt? Is it?
I don't think it's in.
Oh, it is. Look at that. I was like, it looked like it was close. I didn't know if it was or not, but. Did you pick the black book? Ah, gotcha.
That's all of them.
When is Horror Day with Lethal Company? Oh, shit. You know, I've heard Lethal Company is, like, a really good game, and I really want to try it. I gotta find, like, a good, like, I gotta find, like, my friends that have it or friends that would be into playing it. I feel like Nick would be down to play it. So it looks like that one is out there. But that's fine. We can figure that out.
I just want to know how to get into that room.
the one that I was just trying to get into.
Yeah, because we saw where the pocket dimension is.
Yeah, but it was blocked off at the time.
Maybe?
I heard something. What's up, bro? I have not heard of Black Book. What is shooting? Can I go out here? No, right? That's not here. Yeah. I have not heard of Black Book. I have heard of Lethal Company, though. Is that what it... Oh, wait.
Tell me when you finish reading that.
I'm done. Wrong. That was good.
Alright. Now, this is probably where we can get all that shit.
Yeah. You're definitely right.
Everything got fired, too.
Absolutely. It happens. Just happened to be on fire a lot of times. It went down. What's my first one? And how the hell do I get up from here? I don't think I should have been on. But I was. Oh, now
we'll
see it.
There we go. Now give me my money.
Yeah, but you know, I'm gonna unclick this because I don't want to keep trying to pay attention. Yeah. Wow, how do I get to it though? That's weird. Oh well, whatever. We'll figure it out at some point.
Quickly, we must get across to the maximum security platform.
I think this gun has an overheating safety on it.
Okay, that makes sense, because I was shooting it for a while.
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, let's go for the drill. Oh my god, I'm actually almost dead. I'm just realizing that. I gotta be a little bit more careful. And that now, that's out. About which is that battle demons? Interesting. When you ask me to pick a number, oh, although the outbreak and used two urban mysticus and didn't get a shiny Sylveon, so you restarted. Gotcha. Well, I wish you luck this next time. Whoa, that's not what I thought that was going to be.
What? Oh no.
Pickle gas? I climb up.
What? Ratchet, quickly, get us out of here. Hit those buttons to open the door.
Whoa, camera?
that.
Yeah. Jump over the fire. It's not just for show, it will hurt you.
I just realized that there's a timer in the top left.
Oh god. Me too. I'm fine. Oh, thank god I'm fine. Their cell. It went outside. Went outside? Where am I? Okay, yes, yeah, so we probably missed that stuff, but we can come back.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure if it was gonna have us, like, go back a different way, or.
Where the place would have been. There, quickly,
we must slingshot onto that evacuation platform. Oh god. Oh god, I wasn't sure where I was looking, and let me tell you, that wasn't it. Whee! I tried hitting X to launch, but I wasn't sure. Clearly that wasn't the button. Alright. My god, we have so many bolts! That's the case. Let's go buzzword. Come on,
now. If they get away, we may lose them entirely.
Going as fast as I can. There's some troopers here who really want to see them go.
How many of these fucking bolts are we gonna have by the end of this game? Like, holy shit. Whoa. Your weapon to level up. Oh yeah, this is a huge ass platform. Holy shit. Are these gonna spawn into me? I'm actually wondering.
I blown up the ship.
Yeah. Oh my god. Actually, where's the ship? Did it already fly away?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was gonna say I don't see it now, but. I want to get all the boxes. I want to make sure I clean this place up before I move on. Safe. All right, that's fine. I don't think actually.
course that didn't do me well.
Big easy target stuff. That's fine. Get a couple shots on the headhunter, that should really do some damage. Okay. Drill Hound! Is that gonna hit it? I don't know how airborne this thing goes.
It gets some range when it gets going.
Yeah. That's crazy.
Just tidy up the ones behind you.
Okay, this is good. Nice.
Quickly, use that crank to pull the cell back toward us.
I forgot that we actually have a level. Honestly. I'm gonna catch up on chat in just a minute. Okay, so any boxes that I have.
Yes, Envy, I would very much like to try it.
What is she?
She posted a picture in the food channel on the Discord.
Looks good. What is it?
I have no idea.
Looks like most of the boxes I missed were, like, were just ammo boxes, but I may not have missed them. They may have, like, spawned.
Envy, what is it?
I like the cat message from Clang. With the shiny sandwich and the charm, you kill 60 plus of the Pokemon in a row. You can get like 1 in 512 odds, and that's really good. Are you? Give us a minute. Just spent like 1 mil messing with car upgrades. Pluto needs the money in GTA. We'll meet you at the ship.
Clank told me I should try to forgive you. I am going back to Savali. I never should have.
Wait. You're just gonna hide again? Now?
I am very...
Okay, so what happened with Kit? We found out at the end of the last stream. Was Kit the reason that...
Ribbit's missing an arm?
Yes.
Yeah.
I am not a good partner.
Well, maybe you could be. If you'd stopped to help me that night instead of running away, things could have been different. Or if you just told the truth, maybe...
Why do none of you understand? I am broken.
I don't know if they did it on purpose or not, but I think it's kind of poetic that the arm that they gave Rivet is the same color as Kit. I don't know if they did that on purpose or not, but I thought that was pretty cool.
I don't need a partner anyway.
Who's the guy in the back?
That's Phantom. He's the one that
helped us get here. He was the pirate guy?
No, he was from the first world when we got into this universe.
Oh. Okay, yeah, so we should be able to go back and get that pocket dimension in the last couple. I love his goatee, man. He's just in the back, he's like, Wonder when we're gonna get out of here.
In Ratchet's universe, he is literally just like a deadbeat stoner on Captain Quark's team.
I love that. That's incredible. You're just gonna give up on her because you're afraid? Says the big hero who's too scared to look for the other Lombaxes. At least my fear makes sense. Sorry.
Sorry.
I feel like he didn't change that much.
Nah.
That's cool. Oh my god, do we get the next tournament?
You're all okay! Oh, thank goodness. We were so worried.
I always forget that these guys are just... They were from the first planet we went to, right? Hey, Sargasso?
Mm-hmm. I think I know how we can find the Emperor. When you're ready to take the fight to him, come talk to
so
me.
So now I am a little bit happier that we didn't just decide to try and finish this the other night, because I thought we were right there. But I guess we weren't.
Thanks okay. For bailing
us out, so... collectibles. Oh, wait. That's not right. Okay. I'm fine with this. You can always cut on me if you're in the right spot. So we have to talk to Quark, I would take it to Cassini.
Right. Well, sorry. One sec. Is Suki gonna bring my... Hold that thought.
Nothing like a nice... But...
Let's... Yep. Survive. Oh, okay.
I'm down to start these. You good for it?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Randomized weapon.
I'll take the first one. What was the second one? Survive with random weapons?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome. You guys been watching any anime? Not too much. Still One Piece. Satch Bell, I shouldn't have broken that. Why did I do that? Alright. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and use some of our best weapons because... Am I supposed to kill this thing, or...?
Yeah.
Oh, not that thing. That thing is just going to do that a lot.
Yeah.
Okay. So I just have to actually survive the other waves with it. Okay. Alright, we can do that. It doesn't say how many waves there are, does it?
No, but I think it's usually 5.
That's right. It comes in quick. Like, unless I'm watching it. I don't actually know what it's doing. Couldn't get out of the way of that one in time. Okay, so I haven't gotten it. I'll just use the last shotgun. The X gear, is that the shotgun?
Yeah.
Thank you for that. Oh, Oh, that one was really easy. Nice.
Woo! Still One Piece like 500th time? Dude, you're not wrong. You're watching Jujutsu Kaisen?
I am watching Jujutsu Kaisen with my girlfriend. I haven't watched it in a little bit now. We've been busy with other things, but yes, I'm watching that and Demon Slayer as well, technically. All right. Defeat three waves using the Headhunter. That'll be fun, but fight with randomized weapons we could do.
Room rounds. Low gravity, that's cool.
And then the last one we probably just got after we do the others. While you're doing this one, I'm going to make a peanut butter sandwich really quick. Do you want anything for lunch?
Sure.
I got those little pizzas. Let me see what else I have. Every 5 kills, little Zircon will swap your weapon for a new one! Actually, I think I have one of these. White Castle cheese burgers. Let me see what else I have on the table.
Maybe we should have upgraded this gun. So much money. Three waves using the Headhunter. Boom, boom. Hmm. Okay, well, fuck you too.
Having problems with
his ESPN
password and shit like that.
Ah, so
I started up the next one.
Yeah, no
problem. How's this one going?
Bad.
Heard those are both very good. Klingon, what kind of anime do you watch?
Do you watch? Okay, the only thing that can make this person more like me is if they watch One Piece. That's the only thing. That's the only thing missing.
So that sandwich is about 9 tomato slices, 3 cucumbers, 3 pickles, and Pokemon jokes called Urban Mystica. I love that, Andy.
Oh, crazy good. I am very excited to start Jak and Daxter. Absolutely. I had it downloaded and everything. We are all set to go. We got some other random stuff to do in Ratchet and Clank, but it seems like we shouldn't be doing stuff for too much longer. How was the random weapon one? Fine.
Until it gave me Mr. Fungus.
Especially that we didn't upgrade it at all. That must have been a rough one.
Yes.
And this is just all on the headhunter.
Yep.
Gotcha. Nah, I'm very hyped for it. Yeah, Blood Trip has only played the first Jak and Dax, or the second Jak and Jak.
Just say Jak 2.
Wait. Has only played Jak 2. I was about to call it Dak 2, and I would have just given up. I would have just ended stream if I fucked up again. But we're good. Cool, dude.
Yes.
Now,
Pluto typed in 0 out of 10 excited. Okay. I was like, that could have been a very funny typo. Let me try the next one.
Yeah.
Let's see. We have 125,000 bolts?
I got a lot of bolts from the random tournament.
Holy shit.
Alright.
Oh my god.
I think this one is literally just low gravity.
Yeah. We could work with that. That was fun. I should probably not be using lightning strike if there's no one else around him, but at this point I'm almost out of ammo in it, so may as well just fucking finish it out. Of course, now they all spawn. Oh yeah, these guys get a lot of health. I'm seeing the challenge on it, actually. Oh, shit. It also doesn't help that these guys have the most health that I've ever had for an enemy. Holy shit. Everything else in the other round is dying in, like, one hit from this gun. Uh-oh. Oh, I didn't even use it though. I didn't strike that round, but I guess that still had some, I need some help.
The one on the other side. Yep.
Over here.
Is expecting the little guys.
Yeah, I was like... They might have an invincibility frame where they don't actually take damage for a second after I hit them. Because that's the only thing that makes sense here, honestly. Still nothing on the blast pistol. I have something on the light gun. Makes sense that they give a lot of the flying enemies.
Yeah.
But he died relatively quick. You can handle that. I would honestly, I'd prefer a lot more of the flying enemies that are still like a little bit harder, but like I just don't like these guys. Whoever you are right now, I'm unsure. Okay. Oh, that was it. Oh, okay. I'm glad that was a 3-round one. Take it.
Yeah, all the spy bucks.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Who's playing the Ratchet and Clank games again? This one's always looked sick and I didn't take the plunge. Have you played a lot of the other ones, Clangin'? This is my first one since Ratchet Deadlock. And I know Deadlock is like the odd one out of the series, so I feel like this is my true first Ratchet Clank. The original trilogy, gotcha. I've heard they're incredible. I know Bloodthirst played a couple of them. The Apocalypse Glove might actually help with the small guys. I'd love to play the original trilogy, though. I never have. And same with Jak and Daxter. I've never played any of those games. Sly Cooper was the Sony platformer for me. That's what I played when I was younger. Of all the Final Fantasy games, Final Fantasy VIII is still my favorite, definitely not a fan favorite. I've also never played 8, but one of my friends just tells me all the time, like, you gotta try it. That's with Squall, right? 8 has Leon. So flies fantastic. I'm hoping to do a subathon early January, or like early next year, whether it's in January or February. And with that, one of the sub goals I'm going to do is like do a speed run playthrough of the slide trilogy. What are you doing to this poor dinosaur? What kind of this? Is that the bug blades?
Yeah.
Holy crap. That looked like they were just blowing him up. I loved it. I got no time for shields. You need a squall, gotcha. I gotta think of some other sub goals I'm gonna throw in. But hopefully we hit that one, because I would love to do it. I know there's a couple people who have been asking for it too, so hopefully we'll get to do it. I watched that XP bar go up. That was insane. Go for lightning strike. That might be able to finish him out. Klingon, that sounds awesome. I've never played any of the Metroid series, always wanted to. I'll definitely catch that. Some of them look so cool. Nice. Oh shit. Woo! I thought that was gonna be like a boss rush. Sounds good, Amby. So was that it?
I think so.
Interesting. So it looks like we're missing two armor pieces altogether. How do I... Interesting that there aren't, like... Hold on, can I leave? Can I go back to the ship?
Do not forget your weapons. You will need them to keep the Emperor.
Don't think we're ending this now.
I don't think the dimensions can take much more.
I saw a ship. I was like, oh, that might be ours. Let's see. Because now I'm just curious. Done with that.
Final assault.
I'm done with that, but that's where we have to go. Done with this. Done with that. We're good. So we have one armor pod there. Interesting. But we're missing two pieces of armor? Alright, here, let's go back here. Really quick. Oh, this was the prison that we were just on, obviously. Okay. So let's see if we can grab it really quick. Late to the party, only started playing Metroid a few years ago, and it's probably my favorite series now. Definitely recommend checking them out. I know... What came out recently? Was it Metroid Dread?
Maybe?
That sounds like it was a newer one. I'm not sure. Which one did you start with? Oh, so it pulled... Oh.
I wonder if Kit made it back to Savali.
Let's see if we can go through the store. It must have been locked before, because that would have been... There's no way you didn't try that door.
Yeah.
That's hilarious, though. Yeah, holy shit, we have 150,000 volts? Why? What am I gonna have to buy? Okay, I thought I was gonna, like, boost.
You need
me
the
off.
Slail. Eh, snail thing.
The slail. I like it. I now see it. I now see it. Do it! Oh god, I wasn't ready! I wasn't ready! This is gonna throw me on top of another snail, isn't it?
Yep.
Oh god.
Circle.
This one's getting me, but you're right. Oh! Well, that's unfortunate. I am now seeing... I was gonna do the same thing I did the first time. Okay. I'm in it to win it. I'm in it to win it, guys. Okay. This one's the circle. But not on the first one, it's on this next one. Dread was 2021. Super Metroid was the first one for you. Bless Nintendo Switch Online. There you go. How was Dread? And when you say marathon, which ones would you be doing? Would you be doing all of them and be doing like a true marathon? Or I don't know how many games there are, so I don't know if that's like a crazy thing or not. But all right, so let's see.
That one
because
is
of
so...
the bolts. The gold bolts.
Oh, that makes sense. I need to misbehave. Acquire the rhino. Alright. Alright, so we have
a
decent amount. You want to take care of some upgrading?
Yeah.
You like to do a lot of that shit? Yeah. Pick whatever guns you want. I'm good with whatever. Hell yeah, Crazy Jagoon. I gotta get on the other one. I found the tabs for it and everything, so I'm gonna get to work on it shortly. Like I said, with everything going on, I was a little bit busy, but I'll definitely be working on that soon. Dread bounced in between my top three favorite games of all time. Ooh, really? Okay, here, let me hear your other top. Let me hear your top three. My top three, I love turn-based games. If I had to say right now, my top three might be Final Fantasy VII Remake, Persona 5 Royal, and Yakuza Like a Dragon. I do love Persona. Thinking Super Metroid, Metroid Fusion, Dread, then probably the Prime Remaster. I heard the Prime Remaster was also incredible. So that's awesome. I got another drink. Do you still have... I didn't check upstairs what we had. I'm sorry. Let me...
Sorry.
I'm all over the fucking place. I'll be right back.
Oh. Cool. Rip Space and Time, a new one.
There's like a DiGiorno personal pizza thing. You want that?
Sure.
Okay, cool. Want to see if you can find the Raritanium?
Yeah. I see it.
I'll go. Sure. I'm going to grab a soda and put the oven on for that.
Alright. Pretty sure we checked up here, though.
the oven's on. I'll put that in as soon as I can. Based. Top three of all time are some combinations of Mega Man. Mega Man 10. OG Resident Evil 2. Nice. Shit. I haven't played any of the Resident Evil games. What would you recommend first? But I love that ramen powered. You got soup. I'm glad. A catchy lover 69. For those of you who are new here, that is Ambi Abby. I didn't want her to start fooling you guys. So, okay, wait. Let me see really quick. It says we're still missing an armor piece, though. Go over to armor. Right? It shows 3 out of 3. For almost all of them. But we have one locked under Captain Starshield. Down 2. Is it a place that we haven't been yet? Do we get it for doing something different?
Maybe the next story?
Let's see. Because I don't know if we go to a new place or not. Because we have all the golden bolts. We have all the spy bots. Like, it seems weird.
Yeah. 131, 134, 235, 136, 132, 121, 131, 122, 132. Yeah, that's all.
Hold on.
And I don't see any other option.
Let me see it really quick, because now I'm getting worried, because I'm seeing that this is a big bug in the game. Let me just check my trophies.
38 out of 47.
Is there a trophy? Purchase a weapon. Oh, so there are going to be more weapons. Interesting.
Too fast, too nefarious.
Alright, so there's no achievements related to getting it. So we probably... Basically, the glitch says that we do... That we have it, but it's not letting us equip it and saying that we don't have it.
Oh.
So that's not fun. I'm going to look a little bit more into that and see. Feeling like playing Borderlands might start after Black Book. Ooh, nice. Definitely Resident Evil 1 OG. Fair enough. I'm a bitch. If not, then I'd say Resident Evil 1 Remake or OG Resident Evil 2. Gotcha. I'll check those out. Can't give myself a top three games of all times, but series, you have to say Dragon Quest, Final Fantasy, and shouldn't make me tense say. Persona included. I've only played a couple of Dragon Quest games. Funny enough, again, as the odd one out, the Dragon Quest game that I played the most as a kid, the only one I ever played as a kid, was one for the Wii called Dragon Quest Swords. I don't know if anyone would have heard of that one, but the one that just swing the Wii remote around to swing the sword. It's not a great game, but let me tell you, it's one of my favorites, and I fucking loved it. So, get wrecked, anyone who's gonna shit on that game. But Dragon Quest XI, Echoes of an Elusive Age, the Definitive Edition, is the only actual Dragon Quest game I ever played. Which one would I start with, Robin Power? Should I start with 8? I've heard 8 is like a huge one. I feel that though, don't worry. Might change depending on the day. Fair enough, too. After some consideration, Crazy Dragoon, when I looked on the PlayStation Store, I didn't see a collection. I didn't see a bundle. I just saw Jack 1 come up, 2 come up, 3 come up, and 4 come up. I didn't see a bundle with all 4 of them. But I only downloaded the first one right now because we're not going to finish it today. Dead Space 1 and 2 are also way up there for me. I've also never played the Dead Space games, but I know the remake was big. There's a bad accident on 82 and the road is closed. I did hear about that. Ambi, I did hear about that. My parents actually had to take a different way home from church this morning. They told me that there was a really bad accident and the whole thing got shut down, so. By the shell in town. Wow. Hope everyone's alright. A new nickname for us. Toriyama art makes my Dragon Ball heart happy. Listen, Chrono Trigger is one of the best things to come out of anything. Any collaboration with people. Oh. Nice. Did you see that trophy and go and do it? Nice. That's sick. Let me I'm going to keep looking into the glitch really quick, because I would kind of like to be able to increase XP.
Yeah.
It kind of sucks that that's the one that doesn't work. Let me see what's up. Guy that just got home and she said it's still closed? God damn. Terms of Sensibility, the easiest game you can get your hands on would be 8, either the OG on the PS3, the remaster on 3DS.
Interesting.
Alright, let me rephrase it. What's your favorite Dragon Quest game, then? Persona 5, The Sims, and Pokemon? There you go. So I guess we should just go ahead and finish the game, right?
Yep.
We should have saved.
Okay, we have to draw him out. So I was thinking I'd disguise myself as a robot, but with a really
But I can't imagine it really mattering. So it is 8, okay. At least that works.
Listen closely. Is it fear? Hope? The slow inevitability of death? No, it's me. Winning. What else is new, you say? Quite right, but you are only a part of one dimension. What about the rest? Maybe I'm just old-fashioned, but I think
everyone deserves a little subjugation. I love that.
Mm-hmm.
So, to celebrate such a momentous occasion, I'd like to honor the good doctor who inspired this journey in the first
place. Blue to red, black mask, because Rum Parody Moon, or swaps of Robin Hood, Akechi.
He looks so uncomfortable.
Yeah.
What? My first stop. Megalopolis. Or, as I like to think of it, New Nefarious City.
This has been a phenomenal game.
When do we leave?
Yeah, it looks good. You're great at me. You're red now, at least on my screen. Let's do it.
Right now.
You want to take the final boss?
Sure. I really want Quantum and Captain Quark to meet.
The meeting of the millennium, really. Red Taylor's version.
Can we get Clank a new arm, please?
I know, really.
He's gone this whole game without one.
I bet something's gonna happen to Kit, and we're gonna take Kit's arm. That would be really, really dark.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe not, but that would be kind of cool. I don't think we're gonna take Kit's arm. I don't think we went back for Kit, but I think Kit's gonna show up. So this is where we started the game, right?
The Emperor is truly turning our dimension into his own.
Nefarious is just up ahead.
To be fair, Klingon, she's usually not on that account.
We'll meet you there.
So, you're good with blue. You know who's usually blue? Camouflag. Camouflag doesn't show up. But Camouflag was a different color the last time I saw him.
Yeah, I think Camouflag was green last night.
Yeah, something different. No, he's just like the center of attention. That is true. That is true. So there might be, like, post-game weapons. Unless you want to check her. Because I don't know why there would be any other weapons. That's frustrating that that is the one that has a glitch. It seems like the glitch happens if you die after receiving it. So. What the fuck? Alright, so we got everything there. No more the Raritanium, right?
No.
I like Rivet's Mr. Zircon
before he causes the dimensions to fully collapse.
Welcome back, Axta. Did you stream? I know you said your stream started and everything, but did you start it and finish it now? I was gonna say, I feel like we're just fighting the robots. I love those dudes. This is so cool.
I wondered what that would do.
Yeah! Oh, that's so cool. That is so cool. Can we make the Hand of Doom? I don't know if that's one of the weapons. It might not be a weapon yet.
Which one?
The Hand of Doom? Is that the apocalyptic glove? Is that kind of, is that what that does? So we do have it, Crazy Dragoon. I was like, wait a minute. We do have it.
We already leveled up the Rhino.
This is incredible. We chose it. We did a good thing by getting this before doing this part. Yeah, there's gotta be something that the bolts would be used for if we're getting like this amount of them.
What outfit do we have? Basically. All
right. We probably don't need that on right now.
Nope.
See, this would be nice. Not collected. Fuck you. We do have it. I mean, we would still get extra XP. So you could pick anyone. The Lombax one might not be too bad for Raritanium for upgrades.
It just sucks that we can't look on the map to see if there is any.
True. Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
But we take 20% less damage from the robots with this one.
Oh, that's a good... You know what? Maybe just put that on.
We get 20% more bolts with this one.
I feel like we don't need that right now, as far as we know.
Yeah.
But you know what? I would say either the one... You're probably right. Do the damage one. Because you're right.
Rivet when we were doing it.
That makes sense. Because you're right. Like, we might not actually even get any Raritanium. Nefarious cannot
be far. We must keep oh, now there's a group.
Stream stopped. But I was just chilling and I was like, oh wait, I gotta check if we're still streaming. Hell yeah. Can't watch for longer. I'm gonna go to sleep soon. Yeah, no problem, Max. It's always good to have you here. Absolutely. Two time. Everybody agrees. I had to ask earlier when we were talking music, but are either of you into Coroner at all? This man! Oh, I fucking love Coroner. We actually
saw them with Violence.
Yeah, they did like a... It wasn't even a tour, was it? Was it a tour with the three of them?
Well, Violence had like a 5-day tour around like Maryland Death Fest.
Okay.
Was it last year?
It was last year. It was last May. Yeah, we saw them. It was Violence headlining, Coroner direct support with Exciter opening up. That was a crazy ass show. That was so good. I'm jealous. Bucket list band for you. I would see them doing like other festivals at some time around here. So hopefully you get out to see them, man. They were fucking phenomenal. I really hope. Last I had heard, it sounded like they were gonna be in studio at some point. So I really hope Coroner gets another album out. They're fucking amazing. In and out for a bit again. I have to get ready for work. Loser. Can you imagine working? I say to the guy that works an obscene amount of hours a week because he has to do so much overtime because his job can't get his shit together. But yes, I'm a big Coroner guy.
Absolutely.
It's gonna be a hell of a mess to clean up.
Trixie!
What's your move, Nefarious?
Oh, that's awesome. Yo, you got this. A little popular opinion, I think, but Grin is super underrated in my opinion. That is my favorite album from them. Except for maybe... what's the third album? I'm blanking on the name. Let me just check.
I forget how to steer.
I was like, I don't remember controls. Let me see really quick. No More Color. No More Color is my favorite album from them, but Mental Vortex is a close second with, like, yeah, Son of Lilith, Sirens, Semtex Revolution. I love that album. Mental Vortex is up there with Human for you. Oh, hell yeah. Try to come watch what you play every day. I have, like, the exact time when you start streaming without having to watch the schedule. Well, that works, Axta. I'm glad you can keep making it out. I love doing, like, the afternoon streams to get different people in here. I do usually stream later my time, So I do a lot of late streams, but I love doing the afternoon streams because I get people like you that can come in for a little while. Absolutely. No More Colors, Fantastic Drifts, and Sirens, dude. And yeah, Grin,
shit!
My favorite Coroner song. Oh, shit. Oh, that was so cool. My favorite song from Coroner altogether is Serpent Moves. Period. But hell yeah, Axtra. I hope you get to make it out there some more streams and download more games that you see me playing that you think look good. But yeah, Coroner's one of my favorite bands. Exactly. That's exactly it. I would love to hear what they come out with next. My Spotify rap, my top genre was like rap. Actually, you're into rap? Not my kind of style, not my kind of thing, but I have a lot of friends who like that kind of stuff. I don't even know what Nick's Nick uses Spotify, I think. Oh, but you know what? Nick doesn't use Spotify much. Because we were talking about that. You know what, oh no, Klingon, absolutely, ask anything you'd like, I'm always down to talk music, my man, anytime. There's a band, are you familiar with, okay, being that you're so into death, I have to imagine you're familiar with Obscura, with their newest album of Valediction, they're so good. I want to make sure you're familiar with Obscura before I go to this other band. Obscura's great. Have you ever heard of a band called Alkaloid? Alkaloid, I believe it's a supergroup with Hannes Grossman, who was from Obscura and a couple other projects. But Alkaloid just put out a new album that was phenomenal this year. Oh, that's awesome. Destruction, cruelty, and wanton snobbery is over. Oh, Necrophage is phenomenal.
See, look at him! See?
Well, yeah, no. Very different. Very different. I feel like Ratchet also shouldn't be on this thing, but I guess he has to. That's awesome. Nice. Got to see Obscura and Heavy Devi many years ago. That's awesome. Like a lot of metal music. Not into it, but I like one song not anymore because I listen to far too much. I understand that some of my friends listen to the same Randy, his top favorite song that he listened to on Spotify, he had like listened to over 120 times, and I was like, holy crap, that's a lot. But no, Necrophagist is incredible. I actually fall for it every fucking April Fool's Day when they talk new Necrophagist album. He decided to release it, and I'm just like, oh, every year I am an idiot, and I'm just like, oh, I can't wait, and I'm like, oh, it's April 1st. Every year. What kind of metal music do you listen to, Axton? I know you were saying your dad has all the Metallica stuff. Have you listened to Metallica? Fall for it I get stupider every year when I fall for it each time. I've been getting into a lot of like technical death metal and like progressive death metal and stuff. I love that Doth is back.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Their couple singles that they've released recently have been incredible. And then, oh my god. Yeah, the covers they did of The Philosopher, and then they also did a cover.
Hey, fuck you.
Yeah, from that phenomenal cover of Where the Slime Live with Dave Davidson. I assume you're into Revocation as well. I'm sure that's right up your alley.
I show that to my brother and his friend. They're like, oh my god.
Where the Slime Live?
Yeah.
So we check out Doth out some more. I read that wrong, but it sounds like me. I listened to Doth back when they were still doing music, like before they went on hiatus. I was getting into them right around the time that they went on hiatus, I think. What was their... It was after... Oh my god, wait, I have to check out the names of the albums again, because it's been a long time since I've listened to them. Yeah, they had... Yeah, so they had a Futility, which I think they actually did. I don't think they released that anywhere. Like Futility was like their debut that was super weird and not very polished and also recorded poorly. The Hinderers was their first like true album, I think, and it was okay. Wasn't crazy about it. The second album, The Concealers, had a lot of really good riffs, but their third self-titled album had so many good songs. Nat God, Arch Enemy, Misanthrope, Accelerant, Oxygen Burn, so many good songs. But their newer singles are phenomenal. I don't know, not much in time. Just search up some metal players and listen to it. Some players have been used for your favorites. There you go, Axa. If you have any bands that you look at specifically, like if you pull the playlist back up, make a note and let me know. I could probably recommend you some good music based on some of the bands you listen to. I can definitely do that. Revocation is great, as is Morbid Angel. To be fair, I will say, in Morbid Angel, I like early Morbid Angel. I like David Vincent's Morbid Angel, as opposed to Steve Tucker's. I have not liked many Morbid Angel songs since they got Steve Tucker, and it's not his fault. I think it's just the way they write with David Vincent versus how they write with Steve Tucker. I think it's just a different dynamic kind of thing. Do you have Blast Pistol ammo? That might do good.
Oh yeah, I haven't touched it yet.
Oh, fair. Just shoot him in a specific spot?
I don't think so.
Didn't a couple of their members join Chimera when they went on hiatus? Yes, I believe so. I'm usually not like that. Like, I like the Judas Priest albums without Rob Halford. I'm not a big Maiden guy, so I can't really say that I like the Blaze Bailey albums. But you're a fan of them, right?
Yeah.
So, I usually do like it when they try something new, but I don't know. Those albums just didn't do it for me. Formulas, Fail to the Flesh, Gateways to Annihilation, Heretic. There's way too big a gap there. That's so weird.
And, like, I tried doing the link, too. Really
it keeps bringing back up to, like, 75%. I see what you're doing. If you want me to try it, let me know.
I got it.
Keep going. Judas Priest is one of your favorites as well. I love Judas Priest, man. I assume you are probably interested in their tour coming up.
I am interested, but I still gotta wait and see like what the incarceration lineup is gonna be.
Right.
And it's like I got Maiden tickets for next November at the Prudential Center.
Okay. Who are they touring with?
Don't know yet.
Okay.
But like it's the Somewhere in Time anniversary tour.
Oh, that's
plus
gonna be phenomenal.
The stuff they're doing from Senjutsu.
Right. So that'll be a good show. Honestly, if there was a Maiden tour that I'd probably want to go to, it might be that one. What do you guys recommend for someone who likes the band One Direction? To stop listening to One Direction. That might be... You know what, though? I have to check it out. So, Klingon, just as a quick one-off here, on TikTok, there's a guitarist. His name is Fans. Fans Dream, he goes by. And I gotta find the band name. But he actually mixes technical death metal with pop punk. Now, pop punk is not my thing, in the slightest. So, I can't do it. Not for me. But it's very interesting. It took a lot of time. Let me see. So, one of your dad's accounts just has 16 songs. Oh, so this is
a black album?
Nope, it's not. It's like a compilation, basically. So it might have been like a mixtape that he did. But Metallica has Nothing Else Matters, Mama Said. Unforgiven, Until It Sleeps, and I Disappear. Medley. Saint Anger Radio Edit. Enter Sandman, Battering After Double Kicking Death, Motor Breath by Tyler Fire, Fade to Black Eyes, Beholder, Metal Motor. Yeah, so that's all Metallica. That'd be really cool. So Metallica is one of my favorite bands. They were definitely the band that got me into music here at the end, so I definitely gotta give them the credit where credit's due. And Justice for All is still one of my, it's still one of my top five favorite albums of all time. I don't think it's gonna get topped by much. Always interesting to see what people do with Genre Bending, because you never know what it's going to start, you know? Granted, I don't think a mix of pop punk and tech death is about to hit the mainstream, but it's definitely interesting, and he's an incredible guitar. In fact, actually, the guy who does it, he is a big technical death metal guitarist, like I said. Like, he loves doing this shit. Necrophagist is his top band. And one of the songs on that album that I was just talking about, Hannes Grossman actually guests on the album and plays drums for a track. Like, he's gotten a lot of attention in this kind of genre, and he's known as, like, a phenomenal guitarist, and he deserves it, for sure. Hell yeah, actually get it in there. If you use Spotify, what you should do is just shuffle some Metallica. Check out some of their top songs. I think you'd like a lot of that. But,
this is gonna take a while for this one, but oh well. That's fine. That's fine.
Fuck your mo. Gotta go sleep. Of course, Axta. Thank you for coming out and talking. It's always cool to see you. I'm glad you enjoy your time here. Again, anyone who didn't give Axta a follow, give them a follow. They're starting to stream. They were doing some Ratchet and Clank today, so always cool to support around here. But have a good night, Axta. We'll see you soon.
What have you done?
Fuck yeah.
How's that pizza coming?
Well, the oven is definitely preheated. I'm glad you remind me, bro. I was just reading.
It's alright. Now where the fuck am I? Shit. That was terrible. And my little good job. See, we leveled up.
Timer's up. Sorry.
My suit.
I have a dumb question. Is Metallica like metal music? I know it's in the name, but...
They used to be.
Yeah. So, a lot of people... Oh, my God. That was the worst time to get hit by that. Yeah, so a lot of people have that kind of, like...
Aw, oh, fuck you.
Oh, it starts over? Jeez. A lot of people make that argument. They're like, is Metallica metal? Is it rock? And
I remember I saw one Loudwire article like, is Metallica Christian music? Like, no, the fuck it's not.
That's rough. That's rough. A lot of it is metal. I would argue that like earlier on they were more metal and then shifted to more of a like a hard rock stance. They are still metal with their more recent albums, but they do a little bit of both in the metal camp and hard rock camp. And Metallica is in a very weird position because they're not just a band, now they're a brand. And what I mean by that is like they're the gateway for so many people to get into metal in the mainstream even. I mean, like being in Stranger Things, doing all this stuff. And it's cool to see that, and it's cool to see people get into it from there. But at the same time, they're not doing the heavy stuff that they used to. So I would argue, yes, they are metal, but they do, but they mix a lot in the hard rock stuff. They're more accessible. When you get back, check out the visions and stuff. Stars down the wall, so the racing the transitions are clean. Thank you, I appreciate it. I know that's a real thrashy one. We have some groovy stuff on there. We have some more heavy. Return to the Void is awesome. We actually have the instrumental on the album, the title track called The Void. It actually features a friend of mine, Joey Conception, on guitar, and he is an insane guitarist. He's been doing a lot. He was actually, I don't know if you're familiar with Arch Enemy, he was on in Armageddon's remake of their first album. Armageddon is Christopher Amat from Arch Enemy, that's his band. He was on the remake of their first album, Crossing Rubicon. He's been touring with Dark Tranquillity. He's been touring with Arch Enemy, filling in for Jeff Loomis for a little bit. And he helped me do a guest guitar solo on that song called The Void. So, we got a lot of different kinds of songs on there. So, I'm glad you're enjoying Downfall of Civilization. And I hope you like the rest of the album. Sounds good. Have fun at work, Ambie, as best you can. Hope it's not too bad tonight. Pizza's on, I swear to God. The pizzas are coming. What do you guys want for your pizza? They haven't even ordered the pizzas. Through the fire and through the flames and fire, we carry on. That's just wrong. That's like saying Josh and Drake. You're not going to do that. I feel like the Rhino gun is going to be very good if they're clustered like that together. But how many more bosses are you going to fight? I kind of want you to do it.
Hi, Kit.
Good sense. This gives me Big Hero 6 vibes. Like, genuinely.
What's wrong with Josh and Drake? You can say both and still be correct.
You can be correct, but you can be correct while being wrong at the same time.
I'm waiting for Clank to do this.
Through the carry and on We Fire Flame. I know. He only has one arm, though.
I know.
Has he never done this in any of these games, or can he and just...
So in Up Your Arsenal,
okay.
He is a TV star. Secret Agent Clank.
You were telling me about that a little bit. Okay.
Ratchet is his chauffeur, and there is... one level where you are in his, like, war machine mode.
Oh my god, that's so cool.
Doing, like, an old-school Godzilla movie filming thing.
Oh my god, that's awesome. That is so cool. Yeah, we gotta play more Ratchet Clank games. Okay, this has to be the final fight. But I got through it all last night. I got through the entire Guitar Hero 3 set list of the 73 songs, I think it was. I FC'd 19 of them. So I'm pretty happy with that. I technically got 100% on 20 of them, but one of them I just got 100% on because I overstrung, so technically it's not an FC, but... My bad. And we're almost done with this game. But welcome in, Peter. How are you doing today? He hit you so hard, he hit you into the pause menu. Oh, did we get to level 10? Oh, we must have.
Because yeah, we did.
We have 100 health. Tired, just open up the tab you've had open since the start. Well, I appreciate the work. Well, I hope you get some rest soon. I feel like a lot of people aren't sleeping well recently. Like, I have a lot of friends who are just like, yeah, I wasn't able to sleep last night. So, I hope you get some good rest soon. We all need it. These guys are just popping out of the holes and getting beaten up by nothing they can see. Yeah, Clingin, you think of any band, let me know. We'll talk about it. I know, we were talking about that Children of Bodom thing that was coming out, right? That live album? Or was that me? I don't think it was me and Chris. I don't know who else I would have been talking about it with.
I don't know who talked about it.
But I remember I was talking to someone and they said that Children of Bodom was reuniting for one last show. But it's not a reunion. It is from 2019. The live album is getting released and it was called, like, Live in Helsinki One More Time 2019. So... That, I just heard a single from that was pretty good. Power Trip. Oh, what a phenomenal band. We saw Power Trip twice. 3 times together. He's focused on the fight, so I'm not going to ask him. So I'll let him take care of that. We missed Power Trip for the most... No, we were there for them. Or, no.
We saw Power Trip with Obituary and Exodus.
Right, we saw them, like, full set there. And then, did we miss them when it was them, Death Heaven, Anthrax, and Lamb of God for that tour? I can't remember if we showed up during their set.
We may have. Back.
Is there health somewhere? Oh. Oh, my God. Is that going to start from the beginning now?
Yep.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Power Glove. Power Glove is amazing. They've actually played the Kingsland quite a couple of times. And I remember the guy from Mad Phoenix, a band that we played with a couple times, just another local band from Brooklyn or something. They played with them a couple of times, and I was like, that's awesome. Oh, Power Trip, they were phenomenal, man. I know they just did that reunion show. Seems kind of weird without Riley Gale, but you know what? I'll let them do what they're doing. Let's see what happens. The guitarist has a new band called Fugitive, and every single I've heard has been awesome. Hell's Half Acre was amazing. Got it from after Riley's passing, but now they're favorite beer, so bummed I wasn't in them before. I understand that. I've been there a lot. They were phenomenal. Of course, it was so tragic what happened to them. It's just bizarre, but... And for a band to come out with, like, you know, like a song on Executioner's Path... Executioner's Tax. Swing of the Axe.
Swing of the Axe.
But yeah, love the cover they did with Mark Hudson. What cover did they do with Mark Hudson? I don't know Power Glove that well, but I know they did covers of, like, the Pokemon theme song. I'm probably not going to be able to name others off the top of my head, but I know they did a lot of shit like that. It was really cool. They did Under the Sea? That's incredible. Okay, speaking of the best metal Disney cover, Tala doing Aladdin under the name Taladdin. That is incredible. Oh my god. Yeah, I love Fugitive, what I've heard from them. Let's see. Children of Bodom is a favorite of mine, personally. I've been big on the Radio Disney covers and metal songs. I haven't heard any of them, but I know it's been a big thing, and I have to hear some of them. We've all heard the metal version of Let It Go from Frozen. I want to hear the Let It Go version of Subjected to a Beating by Dying Fetus. The Radio Disney Pierce From Within had me rolling. Oh my god. This shit's crazy, dude. This motherfucker really has all the guns in the world and comes in and just punches you.
Yeah.
What a dick. One of the people I worked with while living in Finland is a lead guitarist band called Gladenfold, also pretty good metal. I have not heard of them, and I'm about to do a Google search. Sort of metal archive. Melodic death and power metal. Ooh. I'm into it. We can work with this.
That's basically what I would categorize Nevermore as.
Yeah. Maybe without the death. I would just be like melodic.
Where the fuck is he?
Melodic groove.
Oh, there
metal.
He is.
You know what? Whenever you get a chance when he disappears next time, let's go grab that health just in case.
Yes.
Actually, there's health on the ground, kind of like right to the left. That's cool. I'll definitely check this shit out. That's so cool. Halma is a really great one if you're not familiar with them. I am not familiar with them, but I have heard of them. I'll check them out for sure. Oh, yeah, you got this. Now you got full health. Here's the earliest stuff. Let me check them out. Look at that. I definitely know the name. Honestly, that's like power metal. Oh, so probably very much along the same line. Also from Finland. Interesting. You know who I just saw? If it's a band that you're into. Oh, they just put out their self-titled this year. Ooh. I'll definitely check their stuff out. I just saw Avatar. And I know he just saw Avatar. Different dates, but we both just saw them within the last couple weeks. King Diamond is another favorite for you personally? Okay.
Our drummer.
Yep, our drummer is all over King Diamond. And I will explain it. He gets the most phenomenal musicians to work with him, but I can't stand his voice. I love his stuff. That does not stop me from listening to King Diamond, but I do always say, like, his voice is not for me, but he comes up with some of the sickest riffs. I like Merciful Fate more, personally, than Kingdom, just because he doesn't do a lot of the falsetto stuff that he started doing with his solo career, but
like
phenomenal
90s
musician.
Mercy is, like... He does some.
Yeah.
He starts getting, like, in the growl range.
Mm-hmm. The lead singer of Volby was a drummer for Death Metal Band in the 90s, and when he got money from Volby, he bought the rights to the band and started buying up all albums and producing their songs because he thinks it's so bad nobody should listen to it. Michael Paulson did that? That's incredible. I know Was he the drummer for Dominus? Because I know he was.
Why are there fish?
Strange. I know he was in a band called Dominus before he was doing Volbeat, and that's why he wanted to get back into doing some of the death metal stuff, and that's why he actually created that band As in Hell recently. He wanted to get back into the death metal scene. I didn't know who he was playing drums for, and that's hilarious. I think Don't Break the Oath is better than any King Diamond record, but I like King Diamond discography more as a whole. Understandable.
He does have a couple really solid albums.
Yes, no matter what. One of my favorite King Diamond songs is from an album that a lot of people don't like, as I've heard, Black Hill Sanitarium. That song gets me every time. That is such a good fucking riff. Oh my god. Ring the bell. But that's, I didn't know that about Michael Bolton. That's hilarious, Peter. I love Volbeat. I've seen them a bunch. Their most recent album was phenomenal, from a band that I really think didn't have the best album, couple of albums after Outlaw Gentlemen and Shady Ladies. They kind of dropped off for me a little bit. Seal the Deal. Seal the Deal was good and had a couple good songs, but overall it wasn't my favorite. And the one after that, Rewind Replay, whatever that one was,
Rebound, I think it was.
That sounds right. I really wasn't crazy about that one at all, but this newest one was great. It has everything you want from it. It has the heavier stuff, it has the lighter stuff, it has the Johnny Cash stuff. Yeah, it has everything, and that's what made Volbeat great. They went all over the place, so when they stopped going all over the place, I was like, nothing more. Fucking A.
How's that pizza?
It's got 2 minutes on it. Okay. Always good to ask. Always good to ask. But yeah, King Diamond's got some phenomenal musicians. We went to see Merciful Fate with Creator back in, what was that, last November? Was that a year?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that was over a fucking year ago? That's insane.
And Midnight.
Midnight was on the bill.
Mm-hmm.
But we missed Midnight because we got there during Creator.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Because the line was still like wrapped around the fucking block.
Yeah. That was brutal. That and Chris's dad got lost, but
yeah.
who can blame him? It's fucking, it's confusing.
I got high.
True. I remember that. Andy the Rock on it. Yeah, Individual Thought Patterns. He had such a good lineup for that album. Gene Hoagland was on that album, right? He was I believe Hoagland was doing drums on that album as well. Michael Paulson is a regular in old vinyl shops due to buying all albums of the old stuff. That's awesome. That's really cool. That's like a perfect lineup. I love Dark Angel. How would you two feel about making a pit stop on the way? Right, he was on Symbolic as well. Where are we headed? I think you know. Nice. This was a really good game.
Yeah. When I left work on Thursday to go to Fit for an Autopsy and Exodus, I put on the This Is Death playlist from Spotify.
Mm-hmm.
And I threw in like the two podcast episodes that dropped on Thursday too. When I left.
Mm-hmm.
So I listened to those.
Fuck yeah.
And on the way back, it got back to death. And with 2 minutes left on Symbolic, which was the last song in the queue,
mm-hmm.
I was able to finish the whole podcast when I got... No. Whole playlist when I pulled into my driveway.
Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect timing. You can leave the credits going for a little bit. It's got like 30 seconds, so I'm going to grab the pizza. You can start eating. I might do some cleanup in the game. I'm going to go in and see what there is to do. But then past that, we could probably just start Jack and Daxter. Now, what time did you want to stay until?
I'm good to go whenever.
All right, sounds good. So we'll just keep it going then. I'm not kicking you out for anything. I know we're going to be doing GTA at some point, but we don't have much to do, so we might be able to start a little bit later. So we'll see what's up. But, Klingon, are you a fan of Control Denied? I will explain, and I know Bloodtrip knows about them, so he can explain too, if you don't answer by the time I get back.
Hell yeah. That album is so good. I might listen to that tomorrow. Almost Crazy Dragoon.
Mentioning Jack and Daxter time?
Yep.
All right. There you go. Yeah, of course. Okay. I'm going to move the mic over so you can have the room on that. Dude, yes. Control Denied is incredible. Yes, that solo. Oh my god. Absolutely incredible. Breaking the Broken and Cut Down are two of my other favorites off that album as well. It's a phenomenal album. And like, it upsets me that they were working on the second album and they have a lot, if not the entire album, done, but they're just not releasing it due to the record company disputes with Chuck's work. So, hopefully at some point we'll see the light of day on it. But, until then. And I also didn't realize this for the longest time. So the first Death album I ever heard was The Sounds of Perseverance, because I was actually introduced to Death through their cover of Painkiller. Same way I heard about Trivium. I heard about Trivium through their cover of Master of Puppets. So
mine was Spiritual Healing.
Oh, that's so cool. I remember that story, yep. Oh my god. And so like when I heard Death and I picked up that album first. And I didn't realize for the longest time that that was an album that they were throwing that to the wind because Chuck didn't want to do Death anymore and he wanted to break it up after Symbolic. So that's why he got the new lineup and he got the lineup for Control Denied without Tim Amar. But the record company was like, you need to do another album. So they did Sound of Perseverance and then ended it. And then he brought in Tim Amar and did Control Denied. I just remember the second was supposed to come out, but fuck us, I guess. True. Wanted to focus on guitar more than anything. Yep. And he was citing Nevermore specifically in his new influences for Control Denied. He wanted someone to have a voice like Warrell Danes for the release, which he got in Tim Amar. Did Amar just pass away? I feel like I heard Tim Amar passed away recently.
I think so.
That sucks. But there's some... Okay, I'm gonna... Can I skip this? No, I can't. Alright, no big deal. Yeah, so basically, Blood Trip is eating and happy, there are napkins over there if you need something. And if you need a drink, just let me know.
I still got my water.
Okay. He was a local here too? Really? He was from Pittsburgh?
Hey.
That's so cool. What was it?
And the credits.
Nice. Oh my god, they gave him an arm.
Gotta love YouTube annotations when they had him.
Never met him personally, but he was a big ambassador for the genre. You would see him at shows pretty frequently. And that's the coolest thing, man. That is the coolest thing. Kind of like Chris Caffrey around here. He comes. he would come to the chance a lot. Like, we met Chris Caffrey a couple times from... he was from Sabotage, right?
Sabotage and TSO.
Right. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and skip that. You've unlocked challenge mode. Keep all of your weapons and play through a harder version of the game to get new weapon upgrades and earn more bolts with multiple multiplier. Create a new challenge mode playthrough at any time from the title menu. Would you like to go back in time before the final fight to finish any remaining activities? Yeah, return to Xerxes. Let's do that. So I'm going to make the save. Alright, yeah, so we kept... Yeah, so that's pretty nice. We keep all weapon levels and everything. So... Let's see really quick. So technically we have all this shit. So let me check the trophies to just see if there's anything that we could do. So there's 7 trophies left. We don't need to do that. That's crazy. Collecting. So technically we only have 6 trophies. Purchase all weapons though. Why? Kill 10 enemies by returning shots with the void reactor. That's how little we use it. Get 20 headshots with the headhunter while they are topiaried. Okay, so 3 of the 6 that we can get are just based on weapons that we didn't use. So, what is this one? This is turn on the TV and Rivet's hideout. Okay, so again, so nothing really that we'd want to go back and do. Wow, I'm surprised there's not a trophy for, leveling up all the weapons fully. Where's the exit? I just want to check to see if there's another weapon. Otherwise, I wonder if there's another weapon that you get through, the challenge mode. Yeah.
That's probably okay. All the rare titanium too, because
yeah, because there's no other weapon here, and we bought all of these. Yeah, so all right, let me check that out really quick.
I never see people talking about them, but have you guys ever heard of Baest?
B-A-E-S-T?
Yes.
Yep.
Necrosapiens? Oh my god, when I heard that song, my face melted off. Their most recent stuff feels very late era death in parts as well. Exactly. Yes. No, I know the band you're talking about. They're fucking incredible. I listen to SiriusXM a lot, and Matt Heafy from Trivium, he has his own show, Chaos Hour, and he plays a lot of them. I don't know how you really pronounce them. The only time I've ever heard their name pronounced was on his show, and he called them Baest, and I'm just like, who the fuck is Baest? And then he played the song. I was like, wait, I know the song. I was like, there's no way that's how you say that. But either way, I love that band. Let me see really
quick. I think I usually say Baest.
That I believe that too. Absolutely. Okay. So all weapons. So we're gonna go through it. So we have the blast pistol. Burst pistol, sorry. But now it's a blast pistol. The executor, which is the enforcer. I really wish it would tell me what the end. Can you go away so I can see. Alright, Shatter Bomb.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Fungi.
Yep.
Negatron Collider.
Yep.
That's what that is, right?
No, that's underneath the topiary sprinkle. Funny that they're not in that
order. In that order, yeah, that's kind of bad. Okay. Ricochet we have, absolutely. Yep. Lightning Rod we have, Drill Hound we have, Void Repulsor we have, Glove of Doom we do, because that's what the Apocalypse Glove is, yes. Buzz Blades we have, Cold Snap we have, Warmonger we have, Bombardier, Headhunter, Black Hole Storm. What are these two?
Which one?
Bouncer and Pixelizer. Can only be unlocked in challenge mode. There we go. So we'd have to just start that. Okay, but other than that, I don't really care to do any other stuff. I don't, like, I'll go and get the collectibles by myself.
Yeah.
So that we don't have to do that. That'll be in challenge mode, so I can do that. Again, same with those three. I can get pretty easy. And then that's just simply going to Rivet's Hideout. Do you want to do any of that? Or should we just move on to Jack and Dexter?
Leave it complete. Move on.
All right. Sounds good to me, guys. All right. Let me go ahead and... Yeah, we can't save manually, right? I don't think there's a manual save. I think it's just auto saves.
Yeah.
All right. Well, if that's the case, then we are done. Let me fix this up. Gula is one of the heaviest songs I've ever heard. I think it's supposed to be pronounced like Beast, but I have no idea. I like Beast better than Baest or Baest, but you never know. Okay. Yep, there we fucking go. All right. I'm going to stop the recording for one second.